I mean, so many things make me much angrier than they should.
Paul Rudd, it's lovely to meet you to talk about living with yourself. Did you ever expect to be running around in a nappy at some point in your career?
I did. It just happened earlier than I thought.
I mean, was it liberating?
No, it was awful. It was also cold. It was cold. We shot these scenes where I have to run around outside in a nappy. They moved it up to the beginning of the schedule because the weather was starting to turn. And we thought, this is good. This will be the last kind of week of warm weather. But a cold front moved in. So not only did I have to experience the demeaning feeling of running around the woods in a diaper, but it was also bitter cold.
So it wasn't like bucket list worthy then?
No, it was there was nothing good about it.
So the series centers around your character Miles, who has a clone of himself. I guess you must be pretty used to seeing your face around everywhere. What's kind of the weirdest place that you've seen your face on?
It's strange. I live in New York, and a lot of times there are advertisements, much like there are here in London, on the sides of buses and on taxi cabs. And there have been several times where I've been in a taxi cab, and I just look out the window and I'm looking right into the cab because it's on a bus next to the car, and that's always startling and a strange sensation. Yeah,
I can imagine. Have you ever seen like any weird fan merchandise though with your face on?
I've seen things from films still I'll see things that I've never seen before. I was working last week, actually, and somebody on the crew was wearing a baseball hat that had my face on it. It just said 60% of the time. It works every time, from Anchorman. So it was the Fantana face. It's weird to...
You're just like, hi.
It's like, oh, I'm on a hat. Yeah, it's all crazy.
So Miles has to live with his clone. I was wondering if you had to live with any of the characters that you've played before, which one would it be?
I played this character called Ned in a movie called Our Idiot Brother. And he'd probably be a hard character to live with because he was kind of a slob, and but he was so good spirited, and he was such a kind of friendly personality that he'd probably be kind of fun to hang out with, maybe a little bit.
He could just like pick you up whenever you're feeling down.
Yeah, that's just it. That's right.
Miles's clone is kind of like a perfect version of him. You're obviously known as one of the nicest guys in Hollywood. What actually makes you angry? Like, what makes you annoyed?
I mean, it's a long list. A lot of things.
Somehow I don't believe you.
I mean, so many things make me much angrier than they should. I mean, there's standard stuff like traffic and people that don't drive well and cut you off and those kinds of things.
So you've got road rage.
A massive amount of road rage. But if I'm... if I stop and I let somebody go in front to get into the lane, and then they don't wave in the rearview mirror to say, like, thank you, I want to ram their car. I get really bent out of shape about it. It's just rude.
You know, if you were to be cloned, what are the things about you that your friends and family would perhaps not want to duplicate?
They would probably not want to see the... part of me duplicated that is just on my phone playing Words with Friends or some stupid bejeweled game, because I go into a complete tunnel and people will ask me questions or talk to me and I'm not even aware.
Just gets over your head. You're a bad multitasker.
I'm an awful multitasker. I can only do one thing at one time, and even then I can't do that one thing very well.